Hello everyone, welcome back to Civil Engineering Classes YouTube channel. This video will be the last video of the subject building material. In this we will be covering lime. We know lime have been used as a construction material from very ancient time. Actually it is obtained from the limestone by a process called as calcination. Calcination is the process of heating the limestone to redness in the presence of air. As an equation we can say the calcium carbonate, that is the limestone, when heated it will get converted into oxide of calcium, that is the lime and carbon dioxide. This is the chemical equation for calcination. The lime, which is formed from relatively pure limestone. Pure limestone means the lime content is more. Obviously the limestone will have lime and some other kind of unwanted material. If you are producing lime from pure limestone, it is called as high caustic lime, lump lime, white lime or cuck lime. It have a very high plasticity and workability when it is used in the mortar. Next process is a slaking process. It is the process of adding water to the cuck lime so that it forms calcium hydroxide, and during this process a large amount of heat is also generated. This makes the mixture swell to about 3 times of its original volume. This process is called as slaking. But the problem is that the slaked lime will get absorb the carbon dioxide and they will get converted to calcium carbonate or get hardened to calcium carbonate so immediately. Because of that we have to use slaked lime as soon as possible after it is produced. So this is the exact cyclic process of the formation of different lime. First of all, the limestone, that is the calcium carbonate, is converted to the cuck lime by process of calcination. Then the cuck lime on slaking by adding water will convert it to hydroxide of calcium, that is a slaked lime. On the presence of carbon dioxide, this will get again converted or hardens to form the limestone, that is the calcium carbonate. Don't get confused between the slaking process and hardening process. These two are actually exactly opposite processes. Next one is important constituents of lime. First one is the clay, then silicates, then magnesium carbonate, sulfur. Let's see them one by one. First one is clay. Clay is responsible for providing hydrolysis to the lime. Let's see the definition of hydrolysis. It is a property of lime because of which it is capable of setting in water or in damp places. That means it can get hardens in the presence of the water or in the damp places. But the problem is that it makes the lime insoluble in water. We know the clay particles are insoluble in water. They will just form a suspension like liquid. It do not solve. It is not soluble in water as like sugar or salt. If it is in excess, it will prevent the slaking process. So for a good lime, it should have a 8 to 30% of clay. For a good lime, it should have 8 to 30% of clay. So that is about clay. Next ingredient is the silicates. The limestone or the lime contains the silicates of calcium, magnesium and aluminium. This also imparts hydrolysis property to the lime. Next one is magnesium carbonate. It helps the slaking process by retarding the setting process. We already have said that setting or the hardening is exact opposite process of the slaking process. The magnesium carbonate allows the slaking process by retarding the setting process. And also it imparts some strength to the lime. But if it is more than 30%, it will lead to the hydrolysis even if there is no clay. Next ingredient is sulfur. It allows the lime to set by retarding the slaking process. sulfur is mainly for the setting of clay that will prevent the slaking process of clay. This, the function of the sulfur is exactly opposite to magnesium carbonate. The magnesium carbonate help in the setting, help in slaking by preventing the setting process. So these four are the main ingredients of lime. Coming to different types of lime, this is the very important portion of the chapter, lime. The types of lime are fat lime, hydraulic lime and pure lime. Let's examine one by one. First one is fat lime. It got it this name because it will increase its size from 2 to 2.5 times on the slaking process. Its volume will increase to 2 to 2.5 times on the slaking process. It is obtained from the limestone, which have about 95% of calcium oxide and about 5% of other materials in the form of impurities. So this lime is called as pure lime, rich lime or high calcium lime. And also, since the lime content is more, it has a perfect white color, so it is also called as white lime. So these are the main specialty of the fat lime. And coming to its properties, it is highly soluble in water. Since it contains more amount of lime, it is highly soluble in water. If the clay content is more, it makes the lime insoluble in water. It provides high plasticity and it hardens very slowly. It is mainly obtained by the calcination of seashells. Since it have a very perfect white color, it can give a good aesthetic. So it is used for the whitewashing process and plastering process. Next one is hydraulic lime. Hydraulic lime, it got the name because it is capable of setting in water. It is mainly formed by the calcination process of limestone of purity 92 to 70%. So the fat lime was formed from the calcination of limestone having 95% of lime. Here it is formed by the calcination of limestone that have a purity of about 92 to 70%. Since it have a very less purity, its color is off white and it is insoluble in water. Not fully insoluble, but partially insoluble in water. But it give hardness compared to, since the clay content is more, clay is responsible for giving the hardness or the setting property of the lime. Since the clay content is comparatively more, it have a hardness that is more than the fat lime. Because of this, it can be used where the strength is the requirement. For the works where the strength is the requirement, we can use that. For example, brick masonry, stone masonry, etc. It is obtained by the calcination of kankar. The fat lime, we have already said that the fat lime will increase its volume by 2 to 2.5 times. Because of this, if you are using that lime in the masonry, brick masonry or stone masonry, there will be vigorous expansion of the masonry and that will damage the masonry. So fat lime is not used in the masonry purposes. It is only used for whitewashing and plastering. Then coming to the classification of the hydraulic lime, depending upon the clay content in it, it can be classified first as a feebly hydraulic lime, that means 5 to 10% of clay content. Next one is moderately hydraulic lime, that has about 11 to 20% of clay content. Third classification is eminently hydraulic lime, that is 21 to 30% of clay content. So that's all about hydraulic lime. The last type of lime is called the pure lime. Its other names are impure lime and lean lime. Lean lime, from the name itself, we know it has comparatively more impurities. It is obtained by the calcination of the limestone with the lime greater than 70%. It have a muddy white color. It not favorable for slaking and also not favorable for hardening. Since the clay content is more, it is insoluble in water also. So because of this, it is used for the minor engineering works. the minor engineering works like the brickwork under the foundation. The fluor lime can be used for brickwork under the foundation. It is mainly obtained by the calcination of dolomite stone. So that was about poor lime or lean lime or impure lime. Then this classification was based on their purity of occurring and their different application. Also, IS 712-1973 also classified the lime into A, B, C, D, E classes. Let's see them one by one. First one is class A lime. Class A lime is basically hydraulic lime. We are done with the different types of lime. Class A is basically hydraulic lime that is commonly used for the structural works. Class B lime has both hydraulic lime and fat lime. So it is used for making of the mortar in the masonry work. It is a mixture of both hydraulic and fat lime. Class C is only fat lime. So it is used for the finishing coat in the plastering and whitewashing. Class D is, it contains a very large amount of magnesium oxide and it is very similar to the fat lime. So the application or the usage is also the same, that it is used for whitewashing and also as in the finishing coat of plastering. Last class of lime is a class E lime. It is the impure limestone that is known as the kankar. Kankar means the impure limestone. It is available in modular or the block form. It is also used for the masonry mortar. So coming to the uses of lime, we all know that and we have already discussed most of this, like used for whitewashing purposes and also used for preparation of the mortar in the masonry box and plastering, and also it is used for the lime production of the lime bricks and all. And next to application is very important, that is soil stabilization. This we will see in the geotechnical also. Lime is used for the soil stabilization. The chemical reaction behind that will be discussed in the geotechnical chapters. And also it can be used as a refractory material in the lining of the open hearth furnaces and also used for the making of cement. So these are the basic uses of lime. So guys, we are done with the subject lime and also we are done with building materials. I know I have skipped concrete, cement, mortar that will be covered in the concrete technology, and I have missed bitumen and tar that will be covered in the transportation in very detail. So if you like this video, please give a thumbs up, share this video with your friends, and please mind subscribe to my channel. Thank you.